Hey, it's Andrew Huang. Last year, I put out my first plugin Transit with Baby Audio. Version 2 just came out and it can do so much more. Transit 2 is my new plugin with Baby Audio, obviously building on Transit 1, which if you don't know, was designed for transitions. We've got this big macro knob that can control tons of effect parameters at once, and you can easily fine tune each parameter's start and end point. So it's a super streamlined workflow for creating really dynamic motion that would otherwise take multiple plugins and lots of time to set up. But while it was designed for transitions, we and our users found so many other creative uses for it. So with version 2, we've leaned into that, we've expanded its scope, and our aim was to make this the number one tool for adding any kind of motion or dynamics or vibe to your productions. In the original Transit, we had 18 effects modules, and we've added 10 more, so 28 modules in total. Transit 1 came with over 300 presets. All of those still work in Transit 2, and we've added 500 more, so 800 presets in total. In Transit 1, we had the macro knob mode and a sequencer mode. In Transit 2, in addition to those two original modes, we've got these four new modes: LFO, follower, sidechain, and gate. This is an envelope follower, so it detects the volume of your input signal and you can adjust how sensitive it is, and then it moves the macro control in conjunction with those volume changes. So I can set the range of the macro, and I can also set the attack and release, so how quickly it responds to volume going up or down. Let's look at sidechain mode. And let's also switch to dark mode, because why not? Oh, actually, let me show you what this effect is with the macro first. So it's like filtering and distorting. Now, if we go to sidechain mode, I can choose my kick drum as my sidechain input. And now, kind of like the envelope follower, the effect is gonna respond to the incoming audio, but not the incoming audio that it's affecting. It's gonna respond to my kick. So it's a whole new way to sidechain, and you can do this with so many different presets and effects. Gate mode, you get this grid of buttons for different beat and bar divisions that will launch a macro movement of those lengths. But while the lengths of these transitions are synced, the launching isn't synced, so you can just hit these live. Also here, the transition only lasts for as long as you're holding down one of the time division buttons. So it's also really fun to just play rhythmically with one of the smaller divisions. So here's a glitchy preset on some drums. Here's what it sounds like throughout the course of the macro knob. Now, if I'm in gate mode, I can play around with just hitting these buttons. And it does these quick little hits of different lengths of effects for as long as I'm holding down the button. There's also a looping mode. And you can make it pendulum as well. Next, let's look at the LFO mode. So this has some similarities to sequencer and gate, but it's just constantly going and it can be synced or unsynced here. Got your beat divisions, or you've got just free running. You can set the range that you want it to be. You've got a few different waveforms, and you can also smooth those waveforms. So here's a dry loop that I'll play with. And now with some LFO motion with different presets. Reverser grabs different chunks of audio and reverses them, and it can be synced to different beat divisions or completely free. You can also double or half the playback speed of the reversed portions, so they'll go up or down an octave. And there's a smoothing parameter that sometimes helps depending on the type of audio you're putting in and if you want the edges to not be as clicky. We've got a speaker simulator. So lots of flavors for those times where you want something to sound like it's coming through a cheaper speaker. Mod filter is an octuple filter bank. It's basically like a weird EQ, and it does something that's kind of like a phaser, but I would say a little less obvious. Even though if you want, you can make it extreme in its own way. So you can adjust how far apart the filter bands are spaced, and you can adjust the resonance. There's also an LFO, and that's where the motion comes from. Loop grabs a portion of your audio, which is set according to this length control, like it's different beat divisions, but you can also do it unsynced and just have a completely fluid change from smaller to bigger slices. You can smooth the slices out, and then there's a mix control. Let's just turn this to 100. We'll set the length control to dynamic, so it's affected by the macro. And now, as soon as I turn up this macro, whatever audio is playing, you're gonna hear start to loop, and also the size of that loop is gonna change. And here's the beat synced version. This is super fun to play with live. Kind of addictive, honestly. And when you combine it with other effects, it's just wild. Here's warp, where you can just stretch and squash time. So you do that with the speed control, where at noon it's regular time, and then you can slow it all the way down to a stop. But of course, going the other direction, it speeds things up. I will note with the speed up thing though, because we don't have time travel technology, it will just loop a part of your audio because it can only go as far ahead as what it has already recorded into the buffer. Maybe we'll get to time travel in version 3. The stretch parameter sets the amount of stretching. So at 0, there's no stretching, meaning that it's literally just speeding up or slowing down playback, and that's why you hear these massive pitch changes. If you set stretch to 50, that's where it will try to maintain pitch across any speed adjustment. Of course, as you get into those super low ranges, it just gets all granular and wacky, which is fun to play with. Now, if you do stretch higher than 50, it starts to invert what the pitch should be. So I'm just gonna set it to 100 to show you. So this means as it slows down, the pitch goes higher, which is the opposite of what normally happens. And this can lead to absolutely ridiculous results. Created additional flavors for 3 existing effects. So there's an analog style chorus now, a retro reverb, and a pitch shifter with a different, smoother algorithm. There's now an EQ and a compressor. They work just like you'd expect, but I'll note a couple interesting things. The EQ will let each band go to silence. And the compressor has a great UI that I don't think I've seen anywhere else before that really visualizes better what's actually happening to the audio signal rather than setting your attack and release with like knobs. I should also quickly mention, for those who aren't familiar with Transit 1, it had this randomization page that is still here in Transit 2. For every effect slot and parameter, you can choose whether randomization applies or not. And you can also set the randomization range. And then when you hit this die icon, you get random presets or just random specific parameters that you've chosen to randomize within specific amounts. Hey, it's me from slightly in the future. I got one more feature to tell you about. There was a bit of internal debate about whether to include this or how to include this, but we are putting it in mode lock. So now that we have six modes that really change how the effect responds, you can click this on if you want to maintain your mode settings as you scroll through different presets. So say you know you want to be in sidechain mode or you already have your macro automation drawn. With mode lock off, that means that most presets will probably load in the default macro mode, but there are some that will load in a different mode if the person who designed the preset felt like it shined in a certain application. So that's Transit 2. I hope you'll check it out. There's a free demo. The regular price is going to be $129, but from now until the end of 2024, it's on sale for $50 off. And if you are already a Transit 1 owner, it is $100 off. The link is here and in my video description. Looking forward to hearing what you'll make with it, and I'll see you next time.